I'm Grace, I'm the CEO of Possible English. Today I'm going to teach you some new words from newspapers. See, many people suggested it's really very difficult to read newspaper with hard vocabularies. So I'm going to pick some words from newspaper, okay? And I'm going to give you some situations, how to make several sentences on your own, okay? The first word is award. What is the exact meaning of word award? So award means top something. For example, if you find a person who comes in a t-shirt to the office, if you find him wearing t-shirt continuously, consistently, you can tell him, you can warn him, don't wear t-shirt. So how can you make a sentence using this word, award? Okay, award. Award wearing t-shirt to the office from tomorrow onwards. So this is the way you have to make use of a new word every day. You have understood the exact meaning of a word, a word. Stop doing it. The next one is drama paid. Might have heard, might have read on newspapers. Drama paid for Lebanon. So you might have heard about this sentence somewhere else. Might recently, okay, the blast explosion occurred in Lebanon. Because of this reason, you know what happened to the people? You know, everyone has lost many things, precious things, even they have lost their precious life. So it has become a very big issue. So after this explosion, so the government has to come forward to help them, and they need to stretch their hands to help them, giving fund or money, something like that. So drum up aid is exact meaning of helping someone in trouble. Okay, so this is the exact meaning. Try to use this one, drum up aid. So I'm not going to teach you only hard words. I'm going to focus on some phrases and idioms which can help you to build your confidence level, and you can make several sentences also. Like using new words, if you make sentences every day, you can build your new hope in you, inwardly and outwardly, right? So I'm going to give you another sentence which can help you. This is a phrase, okay? It's a new phrase, you can use it. If a person promised something before, and if the promise has not yet fulfilled, how can you make a sentence using the particular phrase? So I'm going to give you that phrase. Building a hospital has been a long pull promise of my sister. So what is the exact meaning of this sentence? She might have promised before many years. She finds a very good opportunity to complete that after becoming collector. She can fulfill it very soon, right? So that is her long dream, long promise. So in such cases, you can use this phrase. So building a hospital has been a long pull promise. Okay, have you ever seen the crowd sitting on the road and protesting against some problem and not leaving any lorries or vans or any vehicles on the particular way? So how can you make this particular concept in a sentence with phrase? See, break through the barrier. See, some protesters, okay, try to break through the barriers blocking the street. See, that's the exact situation. So you can use break through the barriers even for several concepts. So not only for this situation, you can just make use of this phrase anywhere else. Telling you from the beginning, concentrate on some words and try to make some hard vocabularies. Try to pick some vocabularies from newspapers and make use of those words in your day-to-day life. That is going to be more and more helpful for you people. When you start watching some YouTube videos, it is not going to help you, because you need to practice by yourself. You need to practice each and every word in your day-to-day situation. Correlate everything. Try to make at least 20 sentences every day and speak with your friends. Interact with your friends. Have one friend, the best friend to speak. Okay, so this is what I would like to suggest to you today. So please follow the rule, okay? So you might have heard about a word, debris. So debris is a word where you can find only the wastages or the rubbish things scattered around or under the ground. See, after the earthquake, you know, rescuers would search of those survivors under the ground through debris only. They just remove all the scattered pieces of materials and they try to rescue the survivors from the particular ground. So reading newspaper is a good habit, and most people regret to do this because they don't like to do it. So that is the main issue. Try to read some words from newspaper, because you may not be knowing the exact meaning of it. So in such cases, you can take your dictionary or you can search on Google and you can find the exact meaning of the word and try to use those words in your day-to-day life. So it will give you ample practice to build your vocabulary. So keep on using the same words. It would become repetition. So don't go for repetition. Try to acquire reputation. See, this is a good example for everyone. So make different words with different situations also. So it's a good practice. I recommend you to read newspaper with the help of a dictionary, or you can search on Google. So it is going to be helpful for you. And I hope that in forthcoming days, you will taste the fruit of knowledge from my lessons. Possible English provides you online course. Kindly read this and contact us immediately. If you find waterlogged in front of your house, who will you blame? You will blame the neighbor who is next to your house, right? And you will call them and you will tell them or you will warn them, dry out the water. If not, I will complain. If not, I will report you to the concerned person. So you will warn them. So what is the exact meaning of this phrasal verb dry out? Dry out, you have to just clear the things. Okay, so don't use remove the water or something like that. Try to use dry out the water and make this place too clean. Okay, so this is the major concept. We use several vocabularies and phrasal verbs to build our confident level while speaking English. Okay, and my next word is hamper. Hamper, hampered, hampered. See, if someone is stopping you to reach your goal, if something is stopping you to reach your goal, you can use this word hamper. Hamper is used to, stop something. My work is hampered because of coronavirus. Actually, coronavirus has been ruling this world and has been affecting many people in this world. So, if something is stopping you to reach your goal, you can use this word hamper. Okay, so this is a unique word and you might have used only the word which is familiar to everyone, stop. So try to use hamper here afterwards. This word is familiar on different news channels. You might have heard about the word fire broke out. Broke out is a familiar phrasal verb. Whether you know the meaning or not, let me explain it clearly. Burst happens in particular area, you can make use of this phrasal verb broke out. Fire broke out in the ground. So, you know, it is like, it is the exact word which can be used for explosion. Okay, so try to use many phrasal verbs to build your vocabulary. And my, present advice to everyone, try to read many books and newspapers. Through newspapers, you can gain many vocabularies and use those vocabularies in your day-to-day life. And practice those words consistently. Because when you start practicing giving some mouth therapies, you can just enrich your English. If you want to work out the things permanently, if you want to see tremendous changes permanently, you need to work for you. You need to practice every day, at least for 10 minutes, sit in front of your mobile phone and record your video and give a topic to yourself and speak for 10 minutes. So this is the best practice and best remedy for the beginners who can overcome your fear. You are unable to face the camera. It is very, very difficult and strange behavior to stand in front of the audience. Okay, so this is the great tip which will be helpful for many people. I feel so.